Do you ever wonder what scares people from India, Indonesia, or Italy? Well, we're going to find out this season on Foreign Bodies, where we'll be exploring these parts of the world, plus we may revisit a few places that we've been before. Join us for more horrors around the world. Foreign Bodies, Saturdays, 1 p.m. Eastern, 12 Central, on Sci-Fi for Me TV.
That's a huge question, and one that I would rather not answer, but I'm going to answer it.
Interviews with writers, filmmakers, artists, and actors.
I was just kind of noodling on this very idea, so it's funny you bring it up.
A good question.
That's a great question.
I love this question.
Yeah.
That's a good question.
Count on Sci-Fi for Me to be there asking all of the questions.
It's a really good question.
Bringing you news and opinion from all over the web. Sci-Fi for Me, delivering the multiverse since 2009.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. It is the middle of the week. We've survived at least this long. Welcome, everybody. We are live from the bunker. My name is Jason Hunt. I'm the editor here at Sci-Fi for Me. We are broadcasting live to Odyssey, Rumble, and Twitch. Our copyright strike remains in place over on YouTube. And if I'm reading it right, and I have been known to make a mistake on occasion, but if I'm reading it right, that copyright strike may prevent us from live streaming on YouTube for the full 90 days that the strike is in effect. Unless it gets pulled back. So I got to do some more investigating on that. Because if that's the case, then I don't know. Maybe we'll have to make some adjustments. Give a shout out to everybody who is listening to this as a podcast. You can listen to us on a number of different podcast platforms. Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Pocket Casts, Apple, and that sort of thing. So you can find us there. And we've got the Discord server up and running. The email address, livefromthebunker@sci-fi4me.com. And, yeah, we're still around. We're still making it work. Even though we don't have the ability to stream live to YouTube, we're uploading to those. And honestly, I hate to say this, but the lack of ability to stream to YouTube has not affected our numbers that tremendously much. Which either is good or bad. I mean, either it hasn't hurt us, if you want to put a positive spin on it, it hasn't hurt us that much. But if you want to look at it a little bit more cynically, although I don't know why you would want to do that. I mean, who around here is a cynic? If you wanted to be a little bit more cynical about it, it basically means that nobody's watching anyway. So, you know, I know that there are regulars. I know there are people that are watching. I know that there are people who do listen, and I am not disparaging that. I really am grateful for the people that continue to show up and to be part of the audience. You guys are great. I I love each and every one of you, and I'm glad you're here, and I'll buy you a Bud Light one time. Some tip, maybe. I don't know. It's this week for me has been a series of emotional ups and downs. I will admit, there have been some times this week, and Mrs. Voss will tell you, if I allowed her to speak on her own with her own voice, she'd probably tell you. Boss has not been a very good place mentally this week, so I'll leave it at that. Yeah, I hear you rumbling around over there. You're gonna speak up.
Well, I mean, you sat there and said, if you allowed me to, and you like to remind me, less now because it's more in my face, that I have a mic.
Yes, you do.
And if I have a mic, I might as well use it. Now, I know you have a button over there.
I do.
However, you also have an audience that would probably yell at you if you used it because they kind of like me.
My audience is your audience.
Oh, yes.
And they do like you. They probably like you better than they like me.
Kind of like the
dogs.
Which
is fine. I like you better than they like me.
And yes, he has been in one of those moods. It's been up and down, up and down. Yeah.
But
he's still
I have felt a little accomplished somewhat this week because we obtained paint for the bathrooms.
Yes.
That's getting ready to go. We have outlined a plan for another section of the compound.
Yes.
We have the frames up for the grapevines.
And they are, and that was a brilliant idea that you went, you found something and modified it to work for what we need. And I think you did a fantastic job on that.
Thank you. So, you know, there are some things that are going, some positives.
Hey, the positives will be if the cilantro I planted actually continues to sprout and grow, since it seems to be the one thing that just does not do me right.
Yeah. Well, we've got that, and we've got to figure out the corn. When the corn gets here, let's keep our fingers crossed.
Well, when the corn gets here, the first package that I have coming was just shipped off today, and so if it took that long to get these three together, it's going to be a couple days before the corn gets done.
Yep.
But I do have sweet corn we could put in first.
Well, and I can tell you right now, we're not getting chickens.
Did I say anything yet?
It's come up. Mainly because, well, one, we'd have to figure out where to put them. Two, we'd have to figure out how to get power and a camera to it. So, you know, those challenges are enough for me to sit there and say,
I mean, technically there's that spot that we've talked about doing a sitting area.
No. And you mean inside the dog run?
Yeah.
No, I don't want chickens that far, that close to the building.
Really? Why? I mean, my grandmother had them running all over the house.
Speaking of chickens coming home to roost, that's where we get into our topic today, because Jonthan Majors, remember we said at the very beginning of all of this, when Jonthan Majors was first arrested and charged, we said, hang tight because the story will change. The story will evolve. And it did. And there have been quite a few wrinkles that have come about since his arrest. Now, we were on the air live during a Good Evening Multiverse. What was it now? 3 weeks ago when this hit? This breaking news. Jonthan Majors was arrested, charged with assault. He is now to be arraigned on May the 8th. And this week, I want to say this was 2 days ago, Deadline reporting, that his manager, the PR company, Entertainment 360, they've dropped him as a client. And this is not the only consequence to all of this. Now, again, we have to remind people that the Pelosi doctrine actually is not a thing. People are assumed to be innocent until proven guilty. It remains the onus and the burden of proof is on the district attorney's office in New York. And whoever is prosecuting the case has to make the case that Jonthan Majors is guilty of something. So the accusations of assault are just that. He has alleged to have done this. But there are consequences, even in the wake of accusations, that have yet to be proven. And given some of the decisions that are being made about Jonthan Majors and his relationships with endorsement deals and representation and PR people and that kind of thing, it has people asking questions about the veracity of the accusations. Although, we're living in a day and age when the accusation is enough. I mean, it has been since the days of Reagan, at least. I mean, it's enough to have the accusation. The accusation is enough to bear, you know. It doesn't matter if we ever prove anything. This is how modern day politics works. We'll accuse you of something, and we'll repeat that accusation enough that we destroy your reputation and any chance of success that you have in life. I'm not saying that's what's happening here. I don't know what's happening here. Sci-Fi Snob in the chat over there on Rumble. Miller beats up pregnant women. Proven. This guy gets canceled before conviction. Well, yeah. Is there a double standard? Is Ezra Miller protected enough? I mean, there's video footage of Ezra Miller assaulting people. And reportedly, there's video of whatever this incident was. Now, remember, in the beginning, when Jonthan Majors was first arrested, his lawyer came out and said, oh, there's nothing to it. He'll be exonerated. The video footage proves that he didn't do anything wrong. And we had the story about the girlfriend coming back and saying, well, nothing really happened. And it was, let me see where it was. Yeah, here, this was the New York Post. Jonthan Majors' girlfriend takes blame for fight that led to assault charges, text shows. This was back March 30th. And the lawyer says, you know, these text messages and everything, all that stuff, this all proves that he's innocent. And yet, we continue to have various different things coming out, because right after that there was somebody else who said, oh, he's been like this, he's been a major problem for a long time. Why have we never heard about it if that was true? If that was the case, if Jonthan Majors were such a problem, then why wouldn't we know about it ahead of this? Why is this incident the touchstone for everything to kind of fall apart for him? That's my question. Because you have here an article in the Los Angeles Times from, when was this? This was June of 2021. This is a fairly positive article profile of Jonthan Majors. He was in Lovecraft Country. His star is on the rise, right? And then you have Devotion. Again, this is the Los Angeles Times. I mean, somebody's over there, you know, for the Los Angeles Times. This was December 2022. He's an up and comer. What happened between then and now that they've decided that it's okay to do this? Because then Vox comes out here. This was updated yesterday, April 18th, talking about various different things regarding to all of this and the accusations that have since come out past this incident where he got arrested. There's people who are coming out and saying, well, he did this and he did this. Are there other things that we need to know about with regard to Mr. Majors? Or is this an opportunity for people to dogpile onto the next success story and make sure we put him in his place for whatever reason? I don't know why anybody would have it out for him. I don't know the guy. I didn't know anything about him until he was in Loki. So, okay. Here's from Vox. The charges may be just the beginning of further allegations about Major's behavior. After his arrest, two directors spoke publicly about what one called Major's emotionally violent, professionally abusive history. Majors has contested the allegations that led to the arrest, and so far no further details about any of the alleged abusive incidents have emerged. Still, the news prompted shock across... Okay, this is irresponsible. No further details about any of the alleged abusive incidents have emerged. And have you tried to find anything? Have you dug into this? Have you asked people? Have you looked for comments? Have you tried to find more information? You're just going to drop this here that says these two people have talked about his abusive history, but no further details about any of the alleged incidents have emerged. Okay? Then if you don't have confirmation, this is rumor and hearsay. And if it turns out to not be true, this could be actionable. This is not responsible journalism. I mean, it's Vox, so that's beyond dispute here. But you don't just drop that bomb and sit there and go, well, all these allegations have come out, but no details. We have people speaking up, but we don't have proof. Is there video? Is there an audio recording? Are there photographs? Is there eyewitness testimony? What? You just have somebody's word? Is his name Jesse? I mean, not to put down anybody that's speaking bad about Majors. That could very well be true what they're saying. But how do we know? And what are the details? All right, so we've got Entertainment 360, talent manager for Jonthan Majors, have dropped him as the client, according to Deadline, the report. This comes 3 weeks after he was arrested on domestic violence charges in New York City. Now, to clarify and remind people, in the state of New York, I think it's statewide. I know it's New York City, but I think it's statewide. Any accusation of assault that comes with a hospital visit of any sort automatically triggers an arrest. So the ex-girlfriend goes to the hospital and has marks around her neck, according to the reports. Whatever that incident was, whether she started it or he started it or they're both drunk and none of them remember anything, who knows? You know, I mean, for all we know, it could have been they were playing and it got out of hand. And she wakes up after being drunk and she doesn't remember. And, oh, hey, I got these bruises on my neck. And she goes to the hospital, gets them treated, and now it triggers an automatic arrest. Whether he actually did anything or not, the fact that she went to the hospital and there's evidence of physical harm triggers an arrest. So now you got the district attorney filing charges. He's going to be arraigned on May 8th. Currently starring in Creed 3 and Ant-Man and the Wasp: Quantumania, Major's departure was due to issues surrounding the actor's personal behavior, we are informed. Major's representation problems don't stop with Entertainment 360. PR firm The Lead Company also initiated a break with the Avengers actor in the last month. As a more minor element of this, Majors and fashion house Valentino mutually agreed that the actor would not be attending this year's Met Gala as one of its guests. No great loss there. If the Met Gala ever went away, nothing of value would be lost. Entertainment 360 and Lead Company did not return requests for comment. Majors has already shot the second season of Marvel Disney's Loki, in which he reprises his uber-villain role of Kang the Conqueror, won't go before the cameras in Avengers the Kang Dynasty for quite some time. Deadline hears there's been zero conversations in the Marvel camp to drop Majors from the MCU. Now, it's entirely possible. It's entirely possible that the Marvel guys, whether it's Feige or Iger or whoever is left over there, could be that they sat there and said, you know what? We're going to learn from Warner Brothers' example with Johnny Depp, and we're going to sit for a minute, and we're not going to act on incomplete partial information. Maybe. Now, Marvel hasn't said anything. They haven't made any comment from anybody, so it's entirely possible. They said they're going, you know, we're just taking a wait-and-see mode, and we'll make decisions after all of this shakes out. Because it could be we get to the arraignment on May, and the judge throws the thing out. It could be that they get to the arraignment, and the district attorney's office says, hey, you know what? We've got all this exculpatory information here that we didn't have before. Turns out there's nothing here. Charges drop. Maybe. Who knows? It could be the other way around. Maybe they sit there and go, you know what? We watched this video and we went through expert testimony and stuff, and we need to throw the book at him. So whatever comes out of that arraignment in May, it could very well be that Marvel is waiting for that. Because like I said, they don't have Avengers set to go in front of the cameras for a very long time. So there's plenty of time and opportunity if they have to replace Majors as Kang. They've got time. They can figure out how to do it. We'll fix it in post. And they won't replace him, you know, CG or anything. They won't replace him in Loki. That'll go out. That's done. But that's not to say they won't recast. They won't recast T'Challa, but they'll recast anybody else. But I think Warner Brothers, the example of Warner Brothers and Johnny Depp is a good cautionary tale for anybody who sits there and say, well, you know, we've got this major star, we've got this actor who's you know, very talented and somewhat well-regarded, although after the fact now people are saying no. But he's a very, very talented actor. He's got a lot of potential. We saw great things in him. And then this accusation comes up, and if we cut our ties with him prematurely and it turns out those allegations were false, then the studio looks bad. I mean, Warner Brothers is still suffering from criticism for cutting ties with Johnny Depp early, and basically looking like they bought into all of the allegations. And, you know, Johnny Depp is a monster. Well, turns out Johnny Depp was not a monster. Turns out Johnny Depp was the victim of abuse. And now what does Warner Brothers do? Because they have egg on their face and they can't do anything about it. You know, a million alpacas won't save them. And Marvel probably learned from that and said, yeah, let's wait and see what happens. They're squirming, probably. And Snob's got a point. Who wants to spend all that money for reshooting things? And we're not gonna, like I said, we're not going to replace Majors in Loki season two. But going forward, who wants to shoot a bunch of stuff and then end up having to miss out? That's, again, compared to the situation with Ezra Miller. You have $250 million tied up in a movie. You can't go and reshoot the one guy who's in all of it, sometimes twice. I mean, you might as well spend another $250 million on a whole new movie. Warner Brothers is over a barrel. And I'm sure that Disney and Marvel don't want to be in that same position. Cam says it's because Hollywood does not care about abusers until it becomes an issue for them. They're just parroting whatever the approved messaging is. See, and that's the thing. We've gotten to a point where we can't believe what anybody says. Snob's right. You know, is the lawyer lying to try to salvage things? Or is there nothing to this and people are trying to make it into something? Who knows? But there are enough decisions being made to drop Jonthan Majors from a lot of things, even though he maintains his innocence, even though his lawyer says they have exculpatory material that says he didn't do anything wrong, even though they have, allegedly, they have the text from the ex-girlfriend saying, I'll do whatever I can to get the charges dropped. Because remember, in New York, the arrest is automatic whether she presses charges or not. That's a part of this cycle. But not only has his management team and his talent agency dropped him, but also there are a number of projects that he was supposed to be involved in that are now apparently rethinking things. This is from, this is Microsoft. This is Vulture, article in Vulture. Several projects in development have dropped Majors from their cast. According to Deadline, the magazine Dreams actor will no longer star in the film adaptation of the Walter Mosley novel, The Man in My Basement, or be considered for the unannounced fifth season's Otis Redding's biopic Otis and Zelma. I believe he was supposed to be playing Otis Redding in that one. I could have that wrong. As for projects still attached with Major's name, Avengers, The Kang Dynasty, Loki Season 2, Spike Lee's The Understudy, and Lionsgate's 48 Hours in Vegas as Dennis Rodman. So those are still kind of in play. Then you have his endorsement deals. The Texas Rangers, my hometown team, the Texas Rangers, Major League Baseball, Texas Rangers, have removed Majors from their 2023 season ad campaign that was reportedly set to debut on Friday. As for already announced endeavors, Valentino and Majors have also mutually agreed that the actor will no longer attend this Met Gala. We talked about that. And right after the arrest, the U.S. Army re-edited the spots that they had because they're bringing back the be all you can be slogan. And Majors was a face that was in those commercials, and they're reworking those commercials to take him out. So they're Army commercials and not Jonthan Majors Army commercials. So now that has people wondering, is there anything to this? If he's innocent, and of course this is where you run the risk. This is where the danger lies in assuming guilt. And this is why it's so easy to assume guilt. Well, if there wasn't anything to this, why would all of these people be dropping him like a hot rock? Uh, I think it's because people are scared of social media. And I will get into that in a little more detail right after this. Stand by.
You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, your portal to the science fiction multiverse. Sci-Fi for Me is about to take you on an incredible journey into the realms of science fiction, fantasy, and horror. Interviews with writers, filmmakers, artists, and actors. Conventions and fandom. Previews and reviews of movies and television. Sci-Fi for Me is working to be the most popular science fiction magazine in the solar system. Subscribe now and enter the fantastic world of Sci-Fi for Me, delivering the multiverse since 2009. Thanks for watching Sci-Fi for Me TV. Be sure to connect with us on social media and subscribe to our channels so you don't miss our next broadcast. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.
All right, we are back live from the bunker. Taking a look at the fallout of the arrest of Jonathan Majors. We have yet to name our floating dinosaur, Mrs. Boss. We have not named our floating dinosaur.
I said I'll think of something. We just call things as they are, like dinosaur.
Floating dinosaur. Well, I mean, we've had names for things. We
could call it the FD.
We named the coyote.
Yeah,
we named
did.
The fox.
Yes,
we're talking
did.
About, you know, assigning a name to the possum that
lives on
the compound.
But I just asked you what we were going to name the rabbit.
Well, he's rabbit.
Like I said, we can name the dinosaur the FD.
No. Hang on. Are you not familiar with the Winnie the Pooh stories?
You know I'm not.
Okay.
And I do know that the name of the rabbit is Rabbit.
Yes.
You got Pig. You got Piglet, you've got Pooh, you've got Tigger, you've got Eeyore, you've got Rabbit. I don't know what the owl is. And Christopher Robin. Did I miss anybody?
Well, you have Kanga and Roo.
Oh, okay. There you go.
You have the gopher.
There's a gopher?
There's gopher. Yeah. But I always call rabbits Rabbit because of Rabbit.
I did not know that.
Anytime I see a rabbit on the grounds, my typical greeting to rabbits are to quote Pooh. Hello, rabbit. I always say, hello, rabbit. So rabbit's name is Rabbit.
I just call him Fat Rabbit, Fat Bunny, Fat Squirrel, because
well,
they're all fat.
There's Fat Squirrel, there's Gray Squirrel, there's Short Tail Squirrel.
There's Mouse,
but there's,
the
there's
bird.
There's Rabbit. And then there's guest office dog Jack.
Yes.
Who hasn't shown up today. So
we got the shoulder pad crew for the birds with the little red stripes on
yes.
their shoulders. I'll think of something for the floating dinosaur.
I'm just saying.
I know.
All right. Anyway.
But
all
of
right.
the dog toys are like straight up.
The dog toys have designations because the dogs assign the word to the dog toy. You have fish and you have chicken and you have
hedgehog and barbell and
it's so they associate the sound of that name with that thing.
Go back
so,
to work.
So, you just push the button.
All right. So Jonthan Majors is facing some interesting times ahead. But I think some of these companies that are dropping him are. Snob says, I call everything by their functional name. I call every person I meet human, saves having to remember a bunch of names.
Or pronouns.
Or pronouns, yeah. Well, and the other thing of that is I find, and the older I get, the more of a challenge this is even, but I find that a lot of times I can remember the pets' names before I remember the humans' names. And, you know, that's the way that goes. All right, so Jonthan Majors is being dropped by all these things. I have a feeling that some of it, maybe not all of it, but some of it is motivated by fear. It's motivated by a desire to avoid the court of public opinion on social media and the backlash and the fallout and the splash that will happen if it turns out that he's guilty of something. But even with just the accusation, because in this day and age especially, but we've seen this all the way back. I mean, look at the Clarence Thomas hearings back in what, the late 80s, early 90s. And some of those players are still around today. But the accusation is enough, and the accusation causes enough damage that some of these corporations are probably gun-shy, spooked, want to avoid those 12 angry, emotionally constipated, blue-haired teenagers on Twitter. And let's just cut our losses before things splash over onto us and everything goes to pot. So I can't fault the companies for being cowards. I also am not one of these people who's big on celebrity endorsements anyway. If you have a product, sell your product. You don't need Nicole Kidman to come in and sit in an empty movie theater to sell tickets to a movie theater. If it were me, and if I was the one in charge of that company, that campaign, and if we've got to use Nicole Kidman, I would drop her in the middle of a full theater, because going to the movie theaters is a group experience, a social experience. It is not a sole, single, solitary, just you thing. That campaign with Nicole Kidman completely misses the mark on what it is to go to the movies. It is a social experience. It is a shared experience. And celebrities, especially those celebrities, where'd it go? There it is. Is that, are we back? All right. I don't know what that was. Okay, we're audio is back. How much? Here I am being brilliant and nobody can hear it. I don't know. I must have hit a button. I guess maybe I hit a button by accident. I'm sorry about that. 30 seconds. You know how much you could do in 30 seconds? You know how much damage you can do in 30 seconds? All right, so you have these celebrities who are paid to pretend, make believe. And why should I listen to you about anything having to do with farming or economics or geopolitical situations or war in Ukraine or anything? I don't care what George Clooney thinks. I don't care what Margot Robbie thinks or Brie Larson or Jonathan Majors or fill in the blank. Now, if you've got somebody like an Angelina Jolie, for example, or a Sean Penn, who actually are active in doing things. They participate in programs around the world for things like UNICEF and let's get all the landmines out and the whatnots. You know, you're doing things that are philanthropy type of things. Then I can see you have opinions and we can listen to those things because you have experience in that field. You're doing work with that kind of thing. But you can't just spout off and expect us to consider you an expert just because we recognize who you are as a celebrity. And I don't see any reason why the U.S. Army would need somebody like Jonathan Majors to be the front man. The Army sells itself on the Army. And the job of the Army is to kill people and break things. It is. The U.S. military, and this is something that Rush Limbaugh made a point of a number of years, the job of the U.S. military, the job of any military, is to kill people and break things. And to make sure you win. Now, I don't need Jonathan Majors to tell me that the U.S. Army... Well, we might need to rethink where our military stands in regard to certain things. I mean, I'm not going to go there. That's not what this kind of platform is.
They are out to, what'd you say, shoot and kill things or break things?
Kill people and break things.
Will they be able to actually do that, or will they end up in their safe space first? Because you heard they have little coins now that if it gets too much...
I know. Teddy bears! We need teddy bears! We need teddy bears in the trenches! I know, it's not that kind of show. One of these days, maybe I'll have that kind of show somewhere. Maybe.
Not on YouTube.
Yeah. Snob says, do those coins work on the enemy? Maybe if it throw them hard enough? I don't know. But, you know, we don't need celebrity endorsements for everything. I mean, I get the corporations wanting to put the flavor of the month face on things, take advantage of their popularity and whatnot. But just because you have a Hollywood actor hawking your wares, that doesn't mean that I'm any more inclined to buy what you're selling. I want to know if what you're selling is actually going to work. Give me a quality product, and it doesn't matter if you have, you know, Jonathan Majors or Margot Robbie or Tom Selleck or Demi Moore or Jim Carrey selling things. I mean, Look at Brahms. Brahms had Jim Varney for so long. Know what I mean, Vern? And that campaign was much more effective because it was funny, but it talked about the quality of the product. All our stuff from Brahms is really good stuff. Know what I mean, Vern? That's what you do. You sell the product. You don't sell the face. I don't care about Nicole Kidman going to the movie theater with a box of popcorn and sitting by herself. What?
Where'd she put the jacket?
Oh. Yeah.
He has complained about this. She walks in with this long jacket on, and then she's sitting down. Where's the jacket? They don't do coat checks at the theater.
She has people for that. Anyway. All right. As always, we will keep an eye on the story because the story will continue to evolve. And as we get closer to the arraignment, we'll probably look at it again, but we'll probably wait until we get actual news of some things. In the meantime, you can catch up on the news. We have, let's see here, there it is, Good Morning Multiverse, Saturdays at 11 a.m. Eastern, 10 Central. Coming up tomorrow evening, Thursday, we're going to be talking about the finale of The Mandalorian over on the Ranker Pit. That's tomorrow night, 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central. I think Michelle from Force of Light Entertainment is going to be a guest, so tune in for that. Hopefully she'll be able to join us, and we'll talk about the end of The Mandalorian. And, Snob, heard anything about a Babylon 5 reboot? There is something in the works. There's a couple of things. J. Michael Straczynski has posted today, as a matter of fact, a heads up for 2 weeks from now, said something about something that they've been working on in secret for about 2 years, and he's attached a Babylon 5 logo to it, but he says it's not connected to the reboot reimagining. So it sounds like there are two Babylon 5 projects in the works. Sounds like. I'm guessing based on the context clues that are in his tweet. So I don't know for sure. Who knows? We could get 12 Babylon 5s by the time it's all said and done. Just because how things work. I do know we're getting a new Stargate. We're getting a new RoboCop. I don't know that we need either one of them. But there we are. But yeah, I'm looking at that. Straczynski just posted that this morning, so we're gonna take a look and see what other information that we can dig up on that, and we'll bring that to you as we can find and develop that information. We probably should ask Straczynski to come on the show as a guest at some point. We'll do that. Oh, Cam says we can name the dinosaur Drifty. Except he doesn't drift. He doesn't go anywhere. He just sits. He doesn't earn his keep except to be pretty and shiny and sparkly and floaty. All right. All right, that's it for us today, folks. Thanks very much for being here, and I appreciate your patience as we get through all of this with the YouTube shenanigans and the whatnot. Rumble and Odyssey are alternatives to this mess. Twitch is apparently working here. We've got Cam over on Twitch, so we got people watching us on all these platforms. You need to tell other people to come find us on these platforms. You know, share the love, share the links, tell people about us, because we can only do so much from here. We do rely on you guys to help spread the word. And you can do that on various different social media platforms. We're on 10 of them right now. We've got 4 different video platforms where you can find us and watch all of our stuff. There's the Discord server. We have a newsletter you can sign up for. I have got to put something out. for the newsletter. So that's coming. That's coming. And then, of course, all of our programs that you can find throughout the week here on Sci-Fi for Me TV, which is available on YouTube, Odyssey, Rumble, Twitch. So there we are. Thanks very much for being here, folks. We will be back tomorrow with another installment. Let's see, what are we at here? Tomorrow will be 574. I've been doing this too long. All right, remember, the government hates you. The media lies to you. The celebrities don't really matter. God has a plan for you, and there are four lights.
Thanks for watching Sci-Fi for Me TV. Copyright 2023 by Flaming Dog Media, LLC. All rights reserved. No portion of this program may be retransmitted without the express written consent of Flaming Dog Media. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.